Breaking Bad is back that way. Up ahead, Better Call Saul. This is from the same people that made Breaking Bad, including Vince Gilligan. We got Bob Odenkirk back as Saul, although he's not named Saul yet. We've only watched three episodes so far. There's a full season ahead. Would we keep watching? Marissa, Roberto, are you going to keep watching after three episodes?
I'm definitely going to keep watching because I feel like the story is going to get better. Right now, I feel like it's moving very slowly. We're getting to know Saul before he's Saul. We're getting to know his neurotic tendencies. We're getting to know how he really becomes this confident character that you saw in Breaking Bad.
Show us the greener. La Policia is gonna come and they're gonna be taking Granny away. She's gonna go to jail. You want that? Yeah, that's right. Play it smart. Okay, good. So let's talk dollar amounts.
We see a lot of characters here that we saw in Breaking Bad as well, which is really cool. But what I find really interesting about the show is the way it's shot. I feel like there are a lot of really uncomfortable moments here with the camera.
Talk.
And I think that's what Vince Gilligan, obviously, he made a name for himself with Breaking Bad by uncovering those uncomfortable moments. You're exactly right. And also, there's so much humanity and so much life in a part of the country and a part of the U.S. that we really don't see that often down in Albuquerque, New Mexico. And I love the backdrop and the vistas, and I love where the show is set and the little diners where the meetings happen. Everything just looks so run down, but also at the same time, aspirational. You feel like this town wants to become something else, the same way that Saul's character wants to become something else. He's so much a nothing at the very start of this show, and he wants to become something.
He does, just like the town. I like what you did there with that. You're right.
I do it all the time.
It all ties together. We do see Michael Mando in this, which is really cool. You might recognize him from Voss. If you play video games,
that's right.
Into
Far
that.
Cry 3. He's yeah. in this. He's a great actor for sure. He is a personal friend of the show.
Okay, well, I wouldn't go that far, but it's really
friend.
Cool to see him take this role on. He's playing a guy named Nacho, and I feel like we're getting to know his crazy a little bit more as well. So yeah, we've only seen three episodes, but I just feel like it's got to start running a little faster for me. I honestly felt bored sometimes watching the show. Like some of the scenes just go a little too long, or the pauses are a little too long for me, and I know that it's supposed to replicate an actual conversation in real life, but I also want to be entertained.
No, you're exactly right. I do think that this has some of the problems in any show that's starting out that's just sort of like a ship getting ready to set sail. There's so much work that the show has to do, and it's hard to watch this thing, especially in the early episodes, and not expect Walter White to walk out from somewhere, not expect all the characters who we love from the Breaking Bad world to come on the scene. So far, I've seen really none of those characters. I mean, Mike Ehrentraut, who was a huge part of the Breaking Bad series, he's back.
Like a troll under a bridge, you must have the stickers or you won't pass.
But for the most part, this is its own story. This is really just the beginning of Saul's career. We don't know how he really becomes famous. We start to see him, he turns a corner in the second episode, and hopefully there are more corners for him to turn coming up soon.
He does. I enjoy his neuroses. I enjoy Odenkirk as an actor in general.
He's very
I think
good.
He's fantastic, and he's really, honestly, he is what's going to keep me coming back for more. It's one of those shows that I know everybody is already invested in because everybody loves Breaking Bad, so I don't see it failing because of that reason, but it does have to speed it up a little bit more for me, only because I find myself not paying attention sometimes when I'm watching.
It's a little slack for some reason, and I guess, you know, we finished Breaking Bad, we thought it's going to be, there's this tight, muscular show, and it's just going to take off, but this is, they take a kind of a little time for this show to take off, but because of the history of Vince Gilligan and the great work he's done, and this team has done before, you can't help but have faith in them, even though this is early, we got a long way to go. This is a big story, and we're going to learn how Saul finally did eventually get his office in a strip mall.
Yeah, I know. Honestly, it's a story that I'm excited to watch play out. I just want it to be a little more exciting. What are you scoring Better Call Saul?
I'm going to give it an 8.5.
It gets an 8 from me.